Hi students, coming to the next topic, that is function overloading. So this is one of the important topic. Actually, I said this is one of the type of polymorphism. A polymorphism is of different type. This is runtime polymorphism and the compile type polymorphism. Compile time polymorphism is also called as a static polymorphism, whereas runtime you call it as a dynamic polymorphism. So coming to the static polymorphism, so the examples for static polymorphism are the function overloading and the operator overloading. Okay, so you have to remember function overloading is a static or compile time polymorphism. So the compile time polymorphism example was the function overloading. In C++ program, you can achieve compile time polymorphism by two ways. So by two ways, you can achieve the compile time polymorphism, that is a method overloading. So method is also called as a function. Both are the same. The function method, both are the same. So method overloading or function overloading. Next, method overriding, method or function overriding. So the static polymorphism, the examples for static polymorphism is function overloading and operator overloading, as I said. So this function overloading, compile time can be achieved method overloading and method overriding. So let us see what is this method overloading first. So method overloading is also called as a function overloading. Coming to function overloading, it is also called as method overloading. A function overloading means two or more functions. So if you take two or more functions can have same name but different parameters, then you call it as a function overloading. So if you take any function, that function name is same in all the classes. Okay, so two or more functions can have same name. So in the same class or in the other class also. So if the functions is having the same name, but it should be different parameters. So that you call it as a function overloading. So let us see the example, then you can understand what is this function overloading. The main thing you have to be noted that it has the same, the function name is having the same name, but it having the different arguments, means it use the different parameters, whether it may be integers or it may use one or more, two or more integers, or it may use one is integer and another is float, like that. Okay, so now I'm discussing about only the function overloading. The function is having the same name, like suppose the sum is a function name. So another function is also having the same name sum, but with different parameters. So this you call it as a function overloading. Let's see the example for this function overloading. So class addition you have taken. So the class name is addition, public. Now coming to void, here the sum I had taken the function name as the sum. So function name is same as a method. So void sum, here I am taking two parameters, int a, int b. So c out a plus b. So just I am printing the a plus b value also. So here I am taking another function with the same name, void sum. So in the same class I am taking the two function names as the same name. This is a function overloading. So here I am taking three parameters. So say two or more functions can have same name but different parameters. So this you call it as a different parameters. Int a, int b, int c I had taken. C out a plus b plus c. just I am printing the value a plus b plus c. Okay, so this is a class addition. A function overloading means a two or more functions having the same name sum but with different parameters, you call it as a function overloading. Now I am writing the main function, int main. So I am creating the object for the class addition. So with the help of the object, I can call the function object dot. So what I am calling the sum. First I am calling this function sum 10 comma 20. Next I am printing the next line. Again I am calling the second function, the same name sum, but with different parameters 10, 20, 30. Then what will be the output now? Okay, what will be the output? The output for this program is, first whenever I create the object, so it goes to this here, and the first parameters or the function is sum 10 comma 20. So 10 comma 20 means a plus b, this will be printed, and 10, it's add 10 plus 20, so the value is 30. So again, next coming to this function obj dot sum of 10, 20, 30 means a plus b plus c. It comes to this function and prints 10, 20, 30 means 60. So this will be the output for this program. So this is a function overloading. Function overloading or a method overloading. Method overloading means two or more functions having the same name, the sum, but with the different parameters, int a, int b, here int a, int b, int c, with the different parameters you call function overloading. So this is a compile time polymorphism. Let us see what is a method overriding, method or a function overriding. So method overriding is also same name with the different parameters, sorry, with same parameters. The main difference between the overloading, that is a function overloading and overriding, is overloading means same name with different parameters. So same name with different parameters. Whereas function overriding means same name with the same parameters. So that is the difference between the main overriding and overloading. Overloading means with the different parameters. Overriding means same name with same parameters. So if you are using the same parameters, same name with same parameter, means here you have to use the inheritance concept. Inheritance should be there if you are using function overriding or method overriding. So when you are using same name with same parameters, you have to use the inheritance concept. Means it cannot be done within a class. So in the previous we had seen the function in the same class with the same name but with different parameters, you are using the function overloading. But in function overriding, that is a method overriding, you cannot be done in same class. Overriding concept cannot be done in within a class. So that's why we are using the inheritance concept. Inheritance, we can go for the base class and the derived class. The same function name with different parameters can exist within a class. So there is no confusion between those because they are using different parameters. Whereas in overriding, same name, same parameters means which function it has to be the at execution time, it may be confused which function it has to be take. So that's why we are using the inheritance concept, so that we can use the base class and derived class. One function can be placed in base class and one function can be placed in derived class. Okay, for this we require derived class and base class so that it cannot be confused. Means so same name with same parameters means it cannot be done within a class. So for this we require derived class and a base class. Let us see the example for this, then you can understand what is this overriding. Example for method overriding. So the class base, first the base class I am taking public void show. So here I am printing cout, just base class. I am printing just like a base class. Okay, so the class will be end. Now coming to the next, this is the inheritance I am using, class derived colon inheriting the base class properties public void show. Okay, so here I am printing cout is derived class. So I written the base class and I have written the derived class. Now I will write the main function. So coming to the main function, so here the show is overridden in the derived class and the base class. Now let us study how these overridden functions are called in main function. Int main. So first I create an object for the base class and again I create an object for the derived also. Now with the base class object I am calling b.show. In derived class I am calling this function with d.show. That's it. Okay, so if you are using the same function name with the same parameters, then you go for the inheritance concept. This is a simple example. Simple example. Don't be confused for overloading and overriding. So if whenever you see the same function name with same parameters, then it's obviously it is a method overriding. So in that cases you just use the inheritance concept. Okay, suppose if it is an same name with the different parameters, write within a class only. The functions can be write within a class if you are using the function overloading. Okay, if you are using the function overriding, you have to use two classes. So two classes means compulsory it should be inheritance concept. So whenever this will be there, the output will be first base class will be printed, next the derived class will be printed. So this is about this function or method overloading. So in the next video I'll explain about the operator overloading. So this function overloading and the operator overloading or the compile time or static polymorphisms. Thank you.